to be a bunch of heatless hairstyles. I'm pretty sure there's 10. Don't quote me on that because like some are different variations. So I'm actually wearing like a variation of one of the hairstyles today. Why do I always do that? Well, I'm wearing one of the variations today, but I actually slept in it last night, so it's not looking that cute. Also, you may be confused, like, what is happening? If I'm honest, I don't really know what's happening with my background, and that is all I wanted to say before I get into these hairstyles. I hope you enjoy. Some are easier than others, some are harder than others, but I hope you enjoy it nevertheless, and let's get started with the video. So this hairstyle is ridiculously easy. You just take a front section, split it into two, and use the bottom section of the two and pick up some hair and twist it until you kind of get to your liking and carry on twisting. The only problem is you've kind of got to put the twist in your mouth to hold it so it doesn't go loose by the time you finish the other one. But as you can see, this is what I'm doing. I'm just picking up some hair and twisting it, and this does look really nice. I used to do this really often in kind of year 8-ish time. And as I said, keep twisting to the bottom until you have both of them. Then I'm gonna turn around and I'm just gonna secure this with one of the thin hair bands, and it should last throughout the day. If you kind of want to secure it even more, you can use a bobby pin if you fancy. I think it looks so cute actually, and it does look kind of fancy, I'm not gonna lie. I think me explaining this hairstyle is gonna be a lot harder than actually doing it. But I'm basically going to be doing two Dutch braids backwards. So I'm taking a small section, as you can see, and splitting it into three. And with the outer section, you pick up a bit of hair and put it underneath. It's basically the reverse of a French braid. So I'm pretty sure you can do a French braid. Well, most people can. I can't, not going to lie. But instead of going over, you go underneath. And I've got a clip in a minute that kind of shows exactly how you do it. But when you get to the end, I just secured it with a hairband. Okay. So here, as you can see, with the outer piece, I'm picking up some hair and swapping it underneath. And I just keep doing this. And honestly, once you get the hang of doing Dutch braids, it's so simple and easy. It's totally fine. So do not worry. I know this looks kind of intimidating. And then again, like I did on the other side, obviously, I put a little hairband in it. My hair does look kind of fuzzy just from doing so many hairstyles in the heat, but if it's nice and straight or curly, I think it would look so nice. It was so humid and made my hair so frizzy, it was disgusting. Anyway, this is a variation of the other hairstyle I just showed you. So instead of like finishing off the plait with a hairband at my scalp, I'm gonna carry on braiding without collecting any hair and braid right to the bottom until I can no longer braid, and then secure that with a thin hairband, and obviously do that on both sides. This means that you can put these braids into a ponytail or a bun or anything you want, and it's just a second variation of the one I just showed you guys. So obviously a not complete different hairstyle, but slightly different. Don't worry guys, I'm pretty sure this is the last variation of this hairstyle, as far as I can remember. But this time I just pulled both plaits to the back of my head and secured it with a thin like black hairband, just like a normal one. And then I twisted the plaits that were kind of left over. I mean, you can see what I'm doing. I twisted them into a bun at the back of my head. And I needed to secure this with a couple bobby pins, but I made it quite messy, and I thought that kind of gave the hairstyle a little bit more texture, and it just looks really cute. It looks quite put together, but like so simple and easy to do, and I really love the way this looks actually. Looks super
so
cute.
For this space buns hairstyle, like every other hairstyle, I have my hair in a middle parting, and I basically split it in two with something called a rat-tailed comb, which just has like a spiky end, and I split it in two, and then with both halves I put my hair into bunches like you kind of did when you were a child. I mean, you could leave it at that, but I think it looks a lot nicer if you put it into space buns. So I'm sure you know how to do buns. You just kind of twist the ponytail around and make it like keep doing it until it looks how you want. I've never been very good at buns, I'm not gonna lie. They always go really pointy and weird. But I used a couple hairbands and tried to sort them out when they looked quite dodgy, and then just used some hair clips and yeah, bobby pins to kind of sort it out a little bit more, and it looks really cute actually. I'm really happy with the final result, and I think it looked pretty tumblr, if you don't mind me using that word.
So this one is a really, really simple hairstyle with an easy twist. So basically all you need to do is put your hair into a ponytail, and I just secured it with a normal thick black hairband. And I basically took a little section of the ponytail from underneath it, twisted it round, and then I just bobby pinned it to make it look, I bobby pinned it to make it more secure and actually stay in place. But honestly, this looks so cute, and it adds just a really simple something to just a normally plain, slightly boring hairstyle. And I just messed this up by pulling out some pieces of hair, and honestly, I really loved this hairstyle. Heartbreaks and promises. So again, this hairstyle can be done in two variations. So firstly, I'm just gonna do a half up ponytail, which I'm sure you have seen before. Again, very simple, but I feel like this hairstyle sometimes gets a little bit neglected, if that's even a thing that hairstyles could be done. I don't know what I'm saying, but I really like this hairstyle. It kind of doesn't really suit my head shape, but it looks really nice on other people, so definitely a super simple one to try, especially like if you're running late on a school morning. But another variation of it is you just twist the rest of the ponytail hair like so, and twist it around the hairband and make it into like a half up ponytail bun type thing. As you can see, in a minute mine isn't that neat, but it doesn't really matter. It kind of looks like a messy bun, and then I just use a couple hairpins, and yeah, this is it. Love it. If you want me, you got to show me love. Words are so easy to say. So this is another very simple hairstyle, but I had my hair in a middle parting, and on both sides I pulled back a piece of hair and just secured it with a hairband, with a thin black one, as I keep saying. Don't know why I'm being so specific, but yeah, it's really simple. But again, I feel like it's a hairstyle that kind of gets looked over a little bit, and this is a super simple hairstyle that I kind of do a lot for school when I have no idea what to do to my hair. So maybe try this out one time. Maybe. Do you miss me like I miss you? Fucked around and got attached to you. Friends can break your heart. So this one is one of my favorite hairstyles in the whole video. So it's a little more difficult. You basically need to split your hair into four sections. So I start by splitting off one section and then tying up the rest of my hair. As you can see, it looks like a super nice ponytail. Joking. And basically all you do is, with each section, is you Dutch braid, what, I said that so weirdly, Dutch braid backwards. And since this does take me kind of 15-20 minutes, because there's a lot of braids, well, four, I'm not going to show you me doing each and every one, but like, I'm sure you guys know how to Dutch braid. If not, I'm pretty sure I show you at some point in this video, and if I don't, I'm really sorry. I have no idea how I went wrong there, but I'm going to come back in a minute when I've done all four of the Dutch braids. I said that so weird again. And yeah, this is how it looks. I absolutely love it. I wore it every single day of my holidays. Literally, it looks amazing. Although today it doesn't look great because I rushed it to try like get it done for the video. A second variation is you can just make them into a bun. Mine is really messy again because it was just for the video, but that is a second option. So I love this hairstyle. Basically, you need to start with two Dutch braids like I did now. They're quite messy because I rushed them a lot. Oh my gosh, what happened to my throat? But with each plait, you just need to twist them into a bun and just secure it with the hairband. So, so simple and easy. And you can reshape it with some bobby pins. I did do this. Also, you may be confused why my scalp is red. I burnt my scalp on holiday when I had plaits in. I know, it's really embarrassing. But basically, just reshape the plaits and it looks so cute. Literally, I love it. Although mine are kind of wonky, I'm not gonna lie. But I did do it without a mirror, so kind of give me a little bit of credit. So I really hope you guys did enjoy this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. It means so much to me. And share this video with your friends if you feel like being lovely. I also wanted to show you guys quickly something I was sent the other day. And before you stop watching, this isn't sponsored at all. I wasn't like made to say anything, but literally this is like my life savior right now. So basically it is, oh, hey guys. It is a mini mirror with a, I think it's, can't remember the magnified amount, but it's got a magnified side. As you can see, it's like really magnified. It's amazing and also really scary when you see yourself so close up. And then it's got like a normal side. But the epic thing is this. We can't really see because literally it's being blinded by my own ring light, but it's got a mini little ring light around the edge. I literally love this. But I will leave the links to this down in the description box if you guys want to check it out. It does come with batteries included. And don't worry, I'm not getting like paid per amount of people that buy it or anything like that. But it's just easier if I link it to you guys on Amazon. But yeah, I honestly love this so much and I use it loads. So I wanted to show you guys really. And yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed a hairstyle video because you always ask me how I do certain hairstyles. So I hope you do enjoy learning how I actually do them. Bye guys, see you in my next video. Bye!